Hi, making some macaroni and cheese with applewood smoked bacon today. Yes, sir.
For this recipe, we're using the 16 ounces of large elbow pasta. You could use the box, any kind of pasta. First, we're going to start off with the bacon. We're going to go ahead and get a few pieces of that sliced up. I got here like 7 pieces with a big skillet. I'm boiling the large elbow macaroni to al dente. And then we'll set those aside.
Okay, now that the pasta has been cooking for about 6 to 7 minutes, you want to test it to make sure that it's al dente, which means not quite completely cooked through, but not, you know, crunchy, obviously. So just kind of have to test that. Just if it's too soggy, it's not going to work out that right. The rest of the cooking is going to take place after the cheese is added.
So here we have the pasta that's been in the strainer. What we're going to do is just go ahead and add that back to the pot. We're going to try to keep that nice and warm. Make sure I don't spill anything while I'm trying to film this. Woo, steam. And then we're going to go back and make sure that our bacon is nice and crispy. Just go ahead and cook that till it's nice and crispy. The crispier the better, because this is going to be sitting in the macaroni and cheese and it will actually soften up a little bit too. This is applewood smoked bacon. This is from the deli counter. This is not the stuff that you get in the package. Just go ahead and it's about the same price anyways. Just go to the deli counter, ask them for applewood smoked bacon. You could even get peppered bacon, or you can get standard, you know, maple bacon. Whatever you decide to have put in here, it doesn't make any difference. But bacon is good. Okay, we've taken our bacon out. It's sitting there just kind of cooling and dripping out. But you'll notice, here's our pan. It's got a little bit of bacon grease left in there, which is key. I actually am going to advise you right now,
save your bacon grease. When you're cooking bacon in the morning, like on Sunday or whatever, you got leftover bacon grease, let it cool or put it into a bowl right away. Let it solidify, put it in the fridge. Some of my recipes are going to ask for this later. Voila, bacon grease. I'm serious, you have to keep this. But if you don't have it for this recipe, just go ahead and use what bacon grease is left in the pan and add some butter. We're gonna make a roux using the grease and flour.
Okay, add a little bit of the bacon grease here to the existing oil. And bacon oil, I'm gonna call it, is actually pretty good for you. You can do some research on that if you'd like, but it's also full of flavor that you can't get anywhere else. We're going to go ahead and melt that down. We're going to add some flour, and we're going to let that cook for just a smidge. So here's the flour added to the bacon grease. We're going to go ahead and mix that in. It should be approximately half oil. In this case, bacon fat, and half flour. So this is actually quite a bit of roux here. So we're going to add to this over medium heat, by the way. You notice that it's actually starting to kind of sizzle there. So if you have some sort of a reason that you'd want some sort of a brown sauce, you let this cook a little bit more so it starts to brown, but don't let it burn. All right, we're going to go ahead and add the milk. All right, this is actually 2% milk. You know, you could use anything. I've even used non-fat milk. And so word said, this is a pretty big pan. And so this is actually quite a bit of milk. Like I said, I want a lot of sauce that's gonna go in this macaroni and cheese. So what we'll do is we'll just keep that stirring over low to medium heat. I might actually have it on medium heat right here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna lower that a little bit to, you know, right around 30%. This is an electric stove. It's but just pretty much about the same for your gas stoves. I like gas better, but I don't have gas right now. I mean, anyways, we won't get into that. So I'm just gonna add a little bit more milk because there's a lot of roux there. This is gonna thicken up. So we're just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna continue to stir this constantly. Basically what we're doing is scraping the bottom and just letting it kind of it's gonna start to basically form a gravy. I'm gonna go ahead and put some salt in here. I always use natural sea salt. So there's gonna be a little bit of salt, not too much. Good time to salt it, because that salt is going to dissolve in this milk. All right, as you can see, this is starting to thicken up a little bit. Sometimes you'll see little clumps of kind of like the flour roux mixture in there. That's fine, but basically at this point you don't want to add any flour to this, because the key to a roux is having the flour and the oil combined before you add the milk. So if you see any of those chunks of flour, just go ahead and smash them down, kind of drag them around with a flat spatula. There's one right there. And so basically this mixture right here, if you were to go ahead and add the gravy, or I'm sorry, if you were to go ahead and add the bacon to this and some little bit more salt to taste, this would be perfect for any kind of other gravy. Mashed potatoes, if you want to make biscuits and gravy, you know, let this thicken up a little bit more, and it is absolutely perfect for that. You can never really have enough bacon in there. Also make sure that you use plenty of salt. Sea salt, you remember most people aren't allowed to have sodium in their diet, but sea salt isn't all sodium salt. It actually has a mixture of things like magnesium and selenium salts in there from the ocean. So even though it is mostly sodium chloride, it is got less than regular salt. So don't be afraid to use salt in your cooking.
Okay, while that's cooking back there, I'm gonna make sure I keep an eye on it, keep it stirring. I'm gonna get my cheese ready. I'm gonna use a mixture of cheeses, and you can basically use any mixture you'd like. I'm gonna use a mixture of, it's already shredded, Costco cheddar jack. I'm gonna use some sharp cheddar, and I'm gonna use a little bit of American cheese. But you could use as many mixtures as you like for macaroni and cheese and perfect this to wherever you want. If you've only got cheddar, use all cheddar. If you've only got American, well, I wouldn't recommend that, but you can do it. But it's good to have at least three different cheeses in here. Three. So we're gonna go ahead and keep stirring this. Just remember, do not leave this for more than a couple of seconds, maybe 30 seconds at the most. Just kind of keep it moving, and there will be plenty of time to rest. Cooking is an active sport, and it's fun.
Okay, I've taken this off the heat here. As you can see, it's starting to thicken, and it's actually pretty much a nice thick gravy right now. And this is kind of the consistency that you're going to want it to be if you make, you know, some sort of a gravy dish with this, because as it cools, it's going to get a little bit thicker. So this is actually perfect right here. Any thicker, if you cook it to the consistency that you want it, it's always going to end up thicker than that. So just be careful with that. So as you can see, we've got a pretty good sized bowl of cheese here. This is serious now. We're making macaroni and cheese. I prefer to call it cheese and macaroni. But there's a few pieces of American cheese in there. We're just gonna go ahead and throw those in. Kind of a random here. Just add some of the sharp cheddar, and we're gonna go ahead and just start mixing that in. This is gonna this gravy is hot enough right now that it's gonna melt, and we don't really need to put it back on the heat because we just took this directly off the heat, put it over here on the counter, and you can actually do this on the stove too, but you want to move it off the burner that you were just using, so it doesn't actually continue to cook.
All right, so I got that mostly stirred in. There's actually just a few chunks here and there of the American cheese. I set it back over here on the kind of the warm burner. It's not actually on, just to take advantage of some of the extra heat. But just, you know, keep stirring this in until a lot of the cheese gets melted in there. This cheese was right out of the refrigerator, so it did take a lot of the heat out of the sauce. But that's okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and add the bacon in there. We're just gonna go ahead and grab that, and we're just going to crunch it up and add it like that. Might wanna grab just a few of the other pieces and make them smaller, but that's gonna be pretty much it. So we're gonna go ahead and mix that in. So we've got our bacon infused cheese sauce. Then we're going to add that to our noodle. All right, so hopefully I can do this without making a big mess because I'm just trying to film and pour this stuff at the same time. There it goes into the noodles. Looking good. Looking good. And then we're just going to mix that in. So, there we go. I'm trying to do this with one hand here, so. This is actually I'm doing a pretty good job. So I'm gonna go ahead and mix that, and then we're gonna come back to, oh man, it's looking really good. Look at this. I mean, you can compare this with your Stouffer's macaroni and cheese or whatever you wanna do, and this is going to be just as good or better. I'm gonna say it's better because I don't think Stouffer's has got bacon!
Did I say bacon is the key? Bacon.
So now we're going to go ahead and pour that into the casserole because this is going to get baked and reheated. You could actually just serve it like this if you wanted to, but baking it, helping it form that little cheesy crust on the top, that's also kind of what we're going for too. So hey, you know, I did this pretty much emptied out that pan just by holding it. Obviously you're going to use a spoon, but I'm trying to film do this at the same time, so this is pretty good. And this is kind of like your I don't know, what is this, a 9 by 16 inch casserole pan, and that's pretty much a family size batch of macaroni and cheese right there. With bacon in it.
Man, you can still see the steam coming off of this thing. I keep forgetting the camera's right there. I'm looking right at you now, okay? Filming with this with an iPhone 5. Anyways, if you have any questions, be sure to just, I would say follow my feed, and because there's all kinds of other little things that Dad is going to make for the family.